Well, hello friends. Welcome back and welcome if you're new. Today we are going to hang out at the house and I'm sharing my cozy home tour for the autumn season and I could not be more excited. It really feels like fall. I feel like my home feels inspired by the fall season this year with colors and so many pumpkins. It's a little outrageous how many pumpkins are inside my house right now. But that's okay. The birds and the squirrels will love me in a couple months when I have a feast for them. But beyond that, I'm just excited to take you around today to hang out and share my home for fall 2023. Before we continue on in today's home tour, I did want to stop really quick and thank today's video sponsor, Birch Living. If you don't know who Birch is, they create beautiful mattresses with organic, natural materials that are sustainably sourced. Birch mattresses are free from all polyurethane foams, which can cause off-gassing if you're unaware. And they're also completely free of fiberglass, which can be very harmful to your health. This is all fairly new information to me personally, and I'm slowly making the switch over to these organic mattresses for my entire family. But we started in Emma's room because she was overdue for a new mattress. I ordered the Birch Living Luxe mattress for my daughter Emma, and she could not have been more excited when it arrived. Opening it up was so seamless, and it is so comfortable and soft, and I feel good knowing that she's able to get a good night's rest.
It was important for me to choose a Birch mattress made with 100% organic and natural materials because Birch mattresses never contain cheap, dangerous fiberglass, and instead they use 100% organic wool, harnessing its natural flame resistance. And unlike synthetic mattresses, the wool in these mattresses make it hypoallergenic, so they're both allergen and mildew resistant.
With your Birch mattress, you get a 100 night sleep trial, which is really important. You want to make sure that you're getting a good night's rest, and Birch is there to support all of your sleep needs. And you also get a 25-year warranty on your mattress, which is just incredible. The online shopping experience is super simple, super easy, and the best part is that the mattress is delivered right to your front door. It ships free if you live in the US, so you can't beat that. It comes right in a box, so it's super easy to bring inside and assemble, but they also offer in-home assembly and removal if that's an option that you're looking for to make the process as convenient as possible.
For your little ones, be sure to check out the Birch Kids Natural Mattress. It is a 2023 Good Housekeeping Parenting Awards winner.
I really love my Birch Living mattress, and I think you would too. So if you're in the market for a new bed, go to www.birchliving.com/AmyFritz for 20% off of your purchase on a new mattress. And you'll also get 2 Eco Rest pillows that are breathable and super comfortable included in that purchase. So again, a big thanks to Birch Living for sponsoring today's video, and let's get back to the home tour.
Okay, friends, come on inside. Let's see, what do I want to start with? This is our family room, obviously, and we don't have a formal entryway here at this house. And so you walk right into our sofa area, sitting area, and it's very cozy. It's quaint. It's cozy. We really love it. But we don't have an entryway formally. So I refinished this dresser a while back, and we use it as a side table for the sofa, but it's also a sweet little kind of entryway-esque table. If somebody wants to set their purse down or something, or keys, they totally can if they come over. But on this table, I've got this beautiful kind of sage green, deep green pumpkin. And then I've got this pumpkin spice latte candle going. Oh my word, smells so good from Antique Candle Company, in this little scalloped thrifted dish. And then a candle snuffer. I love these. They're so neat. But really simple, just kind of kept it bare bones on there just so that people would have room to leave their things if they did come over. Hi guys. And then I also wanted to show you, while I'm in the mirror, I have been loving these sweater sets from Amazon. I have two of them and I want to get like two more, but they're a sweater material. It's just a jacket, like a pullover jacket with a collar, and then a sweater material sweatpant, and it's gathered at the ankle, which is just so comfy. I have been living in this as the temperatures start to cool off. And I could totally see myself wearing this on Thanksgiving. My family tends to go a little more comfy on Thanksgiving. I've been wearing it to carpool in the morning at school drop-off. It's like the perfect, you can wear out, but it's pajamas, kind of comfy, cozy at home outfit. And I've really been loving it. So I was gonna share that while I'm in the mirror. But anyway, let's see. Here in the actual sitting area, not much has changed. I have some plaid pillows for fall. I love to bring in plaids. I think it's so pretty. I've got some green and blue floral block pillows from Woven Nook that are really sweet. I definitely went with lots of greens in this space. And again, I let nature inspire me. The pumpkins are green. The greenery from outside that's dried is green. So yeah. And then, oh, speaking of that, I guess I didn't talk about it. I have this big basket on top of the armoire, which homes our TV. And in one of my previous decorating videos, I had a basket up there as well. And then I realized when you walk through the front door, they were definitely competing with one another. And so I put all of my greenery in one basket. And that way it just draws your eye right to that and nothing competes. And I think it's really beautiful. It's a mixture of dried leaves from outside, and I've got a couple of faux stems in there too. And it's just really full, really beautiful. I think it looks nice for autumn. And then over here, I've got another massive pumpkin. I'm probably gonna do something else on this table. I just hadn't done anything yet. Coffee tables are definitely not my strong suit. Let me know in the comments. Do you like decorating coffee tables? I find that everything just kind of gets in the way and the kids want to play or you want to put your drink down. So I like to keep it really simple, but maybe that's just me. And then over here on this side table, oops, my lamp is crooked. I just realized that. That's weird. There we go. I've got this brass lamp. It's from Target. And I've got my little duck decoy and some greenery stems in a little, this is actually like a sugar dish, but I like how whimsical those stems are. They're from Joann's and they're really inexpensive, like $4 a stem, and then you can get them 40% off of that, I think. So that was a good clearance find for me back in August. Huh, Maggie? It's so hard being you, isn't it? She's got her pretty little sunflower bandana on today for you guys. And then looking this way, oh, it smells so good in here. Today I've got all my cozy candles burning. Over here we've got a little hall tree at the bottom of the stairs. And my mom actually thrifted that and she refinished it and then she gave it to me. It's the perfect little piece for the bottom of the stairs because the mirror is so tall. I feel like it really elongates the staircase. It makes everything look bigger and more open. But on the actual hall tree, I've got this little picture of these faux floral stems. I got these, I want to say, at Hobby Lobby a couple years ago. They're really whimsical. I love the color, so pretty. And then I've got a little hat hanging on the hook. This was thrifted as well. So, got that. And then moving into my office, which has been such a treat to spend time in now that it's decorated for fall and just feeling cozy. I keep my desk completely bare. I just work better that way. But I have this light fixture above my desk, and I had a bunch of leftover dried branches. You can see they look very green on camera. In person, I've got some that are a little deeper green, brownish colored. This would probably be prettier if I waited for the leaves to turn yellow or red, and maybe I'll still do that just for fun. But for now, I really love this. I think it is really fun. It was just something fun, something different I've never done before, and I really liked the look of it. I think it definitely makes a statement in this space. But then over here on the secretary, I have this basket that I got a while back at an antique shop, and I wanted to create the illusion that it was just stuffed to the brim with dried hydrangeas. So I filled it up and then I closed the lid on a bunch of hydrangeas, and thankfully it all kind of stayed in place. I had to play around with it a little bit, but I really love that. I think it looks beautiful on top of the secretary. And then on this part of the secretary, I just have some dried wheat, which is of course classic for fall and harvest time. And then I've got a pumpkin apple candle going from Antique Candle Company. And this one smells so good. I love that hint of apple. It's really clean smelling. And then I've got a little pumpkin there too. So that's how that looks. Come over here. I got this iron wall piece on clearance at Home. And I like the way you can see through it and see the shiplap. I think it's really pretty in here. And then I've got this mantle over here. And nothing too exciting going on over here. I had more dried hydrangeas, so I just kind of stuck a bunch in a crock and called it good with a little pumpkin. And then on this side, not really decor, but I recently ran a half marathon back in September, and I actually ended up placing, which was pretty cool. So that was my award. We finished the race at a brewery. That would make more sense, gives you more context for why the award is what it is. But I was pretty proud of that. So I've got that displayed in here for now, and I like it. Let's take a look at one of my favorite spaces in the house right now, our parlor. Our home is historic, and it has a formal parlor room with this big, glorious pocket door. That is heavy. Hang on, I gotta move it. but this room is really like a formal sitting room to us. It's where we keep the piano, but the kids play in here a lot too. So let's just kind of take a look around. One of my favorite things about this space is that it has three windows on all three walls. There is a window, so we get lots of dappled light throughout the day, which is just so beautiful and airy and bright, but still cozy. So for autumn, for just the cozy months, you'll see here, I went out and clipped some branches that I noticed started to turn yellow, and the golden yellow color I think is so pretty for fall. So you can see here, these are the real leaves, but then I just stuck a couple of faux yellow branches. I believe these are from a floral, just to kind of fill out the arrangement and make it look a little fuller, a little nicer. But I love that. I think it's a major statement in this space right now. On the sofa, I've got some block print pillows. I think those are from Woven Nook, if I'm saying that right. And then over in this corner here, on the side table, I just wanted to keep things really simple. I wouldn't even really say this is like decorated. This is more function than anything, but I've got my diffuser going. I pretty much have my diffuser going 24/7 this time of year, and I'm pretty much always diffusing thieves. If you know, you know. But I also added some tangerine, sometimes I do orange, and cinnamon bark, and oh my word, it smells like fall. It smells so good. And I've got a sweet little pumpkin sitting there too. But over in this corner here, sorry, there is a fly in my house. I'm really ready for our first freeze so the bugs die. But in this corner here, I have some stacked baskets, and they're thrifted. I love them. They are such great storage. They look beautiful. In that top basket, it's full of the boys' transformers and a couple cars and things they play with all the time. And then in the bottom, there's some things they don't play with as often. But the top one, they're always pulling down. They can come in here, they can play their hearts out, and then it takes 5 minutes to clean up. We just throw everything in the basket. It keeps things really simple, really, really simple. And then up above that, I actually made this wreath this year. And you can see, I'll get up close, it has a bunch of different colors in it, some pinks, some browns, some greens, and they're all just different hydrangeas from my yard. So I think that adds a lot of pretty color and texture to the wall space here. And then I'll give you a quick little look. Hold on, I guess I'll turn around this way. A quick little look at the seating space looking from the room this way. Oh, I've got an Amazon package. Real life over here. And then over here on the piano, I stacked a couple of real pumpkins here. And then I've got this big brass mirror that I thrifted several years ago, and I think it's so pretty in this space. I've got a little pottery crock down there filled with some dried stems. And then on the wall behind the stems, I have a couple of prints. The bottom one I got on clearance at Target, and I think the colors are perfect for this time of year. Sleepy Maggie. We will continue on and head into the dining room, but before we do, I have these sweet little bird prints on this wall here that were in the dining room, so I didn't want anyone to get confused about where those went. I moved them over here, and you'll see why in just a second, but I wanted to show you guys that, and I actually really like those prints there. I found them at a local boutique. They're not thrifted. If we can find the link online, I'll link it in the description below because that's another one I get asked about a lot. I love those prints. They're really sweet. But here is my dining room for fall. And my favorite little corner is right over here. We'll look at it here in a second. But I just love the dining space in autumn, in the fall months. Lots of cozy dinners will happen right here. Game nights, as you know, the sun starts to set really early. I feel like we just spend more time around the table, less time outside. And I think there's a time and a place for that. And I'm starting to just embrace it and really enjoy when the outdoors go dormant and try to appreciate inside. And one way I can do that, one way I can love my family and spend more time with my family is creating a cozy dining experience and dining space. So I think I've kind of figured it out, but still kind of playing with stuff a little bit. But we love this space. We sit here a lot. The kids are in here all the time. I keep a lot of like their craft stuff, coloring stuff in the hutch, so that they can play and have access to it. So anyway, this is my favorite little spot in the dining room. I love this nook and I made some changes to it. I was out on our land, which I have some really exciting news about our land I'll be sharing soon. Exciting things are happening, guys. But when I have a building update, I will share more. But I was out there the other day and I noticed we had a ton of goldenrod out there. And so I was like, you know what? I should cut some and dry it out. It would be so beautiful for fall and autumn. So I cut a few and I tied it up with some ribbon and I've been letting it dry out now for probably 4 or 5 days. And I'm impressed. Nothing has dropped on the ground. It's been drying out really, really beautifully. And I love that pop of yellow, sort of gold mustard here for autumn. And then I made that grapevine wreath a couple weeks ago now. I just stuck a bunch of dried branches just from right outside and took the leaves off a lot of the branches so that it looked a little more whimsical and I saw more of the stick and the branch of the vine. And so I like how that really turned out. I think it's really fun. So the other big addition to this space, like I mentioned, I had the two bird prints here, but I moved them because I was down in the basement the other day and I saw this sign down there. Now granted, I bought this back in Georgia when we still lived in Georgia and I used to decorate my mantle with it. If you guys have been around that long, then you'll remember, but I saw it down there and I thought, you know what? I haven't used this in a couple of years. It's so pretty and I love Anna Green Gables and I love this quote. Let's find somewhere fun to put it. And so I played around with a couple spots and this is where it landed. And I love that. It says, I'm so glad I live in a world with Octobers. And it's fitting obviously for it now being October. It's just, I love it. And, on the bottom there, I've got a little antique plant stand and some more stacked pumpkins. And I think overall this little corner, this little nook of the house is super cozy. And then on this side, I've got this bench up against the window with just a sweet little striped pillow. I've got the accent table there in the corner and I have that primarily so that I can have a cozy lamp in this space. If I can fit a lamp in a room, I always try. We don't use a lot of overhead lighting, especially as you know fall and winter approaches and it's so dark and dreary. We want all the cozy lighting. So that's why I've got this little table here, but then I've got some more hydrangeas in this little terracotta pot, whoops, and a candle going. And that is always a fun little corner to decorate. And then we've got the hutch, which I didn't really do a lot when you think about it. I kind of just left all of my white ironstone and dishware out like I usually do. And then instead of doing a basket or like a floral arrangement on the hutch, I was trying to avoid that because I'm really trying hard to practice restraint in my decor. And when you look in my home from the living room, there's already a lot that catches your eye in regards to florals and floral stems. And I've already got that little arrangement over there. I added these vintage Crocs to the top of my hutch. I have the 4 gallon and the 2 gallon, and I've got those staggered. And then I've got a little pumpkin stack up top as well. And I think the colors in that bottom green pumpkin with the orange is so pretty for fall. And then in a bowl on the bottom, I just filled that with some beautiful gold pears. I love those. I think they're so pretty. And so I think that turned out really sweet, really subtle. It's not, you know, too much, because again, when you walk through my front door, you see it, but you also see that basket and you see this floral arrangement. And so I'm trying again, just trying to learn. I still have a long way to go, but trying to learn the art of restraint. And so kind of played around with that. And then on the table, I have this dough bowl. It's so beautiful. It's an antique, it's hand carved. I've just got the dough bowl filled with more of these white pie pumpkins, and I think it looks really pretty just like that. And then the last thing in here, really, that's for fall is this pillow. And I got the pillow cover on Amazon. And again, just love lots of plaids, browns, taupes in the autumn. I think it's so pretty, so cozy, a nice subtle way to add fall. So let's talk about the kitchen and what I have going on in here right now. I purchased this pear print on Etsy and threw it in a frame from Target, I believe, but I love the greens in this. I think it's so pretty for autumn, very inexpensive art. One of my favorite ways to display art, or wall decor, I should say. But looking into my kitchen, I have changed things up recently. I've been kind of on an organizing and decluttering kick the last month or so. And so I've got the kitchen in a really good place right now. So it feels really nice. I feel like I'm ready to embrace crockpot cooking, baking season. I definitely recommend going through your kitchen cabinets and drawers the end of summer, early fall, and just getting your kitchen space feeling clean and organized before bringing in all the seasonal stuff. But you'll see here on the peninsula, I left it empty. And that is just because it's the most functional. We sit here a lot, whether we're eating or the kids are doing homework or whatever. I like to just kind of keep it plain, simple. Sometimes I'll put something on here, something small, but for right now, I've just got it bare. And that's okay. This is me giving you permission to have empty walls, empty countertops, empty spaces in your home every once in a while is totally okay. But moving over here, this is kind of my little coffee station, if you will. I keep like my coffee and my milk frother and all of my coffee related things in here, my bean grinder down here. And so my mugs are in there. And so although it's a pretty minimal coffee station, just looking at it, it's just the coffee pot. I've got a lot of coffee stuff going on over here. But my mom actually bought me this coffee pot for my birthday, and it was such a fun surprise. I've been wanting a nice coffee pot for a long time. This one is really, really nice, and I'm super thankful. Thanks, Mom, if you're watching this. I love my birthday present. I've been putting a pot on every morning and probably drinking way too much coffee, but it's fun and it's small. And then up above, I love buying these little pie pumpkins at either the grocery store or farmer's market. They're so inexpensive. They're like 50 cents. They last all season. And I just think they're so cute. So I did a little trio of them there on the shelf. And then I recently went to the grocery store and bought myself some, oh, these flies, I tell ya, bought myself some flowers. And I tucked some of those flowers in that little pitcher there for a pop of color, but really didn't do a whole lot. And then moving over here, most of this is functional year-round decor, or not decor, items, household items that I use. I've kind of got it set up to where my baking station is over here because I've got all my flowers and my KitchenAid. On this side, it's more inclined to cooking, so I've got my utensils and a little crock over there. And then on that tray over there, I have, of course, my cozy lamp on, because in the fall months and into the winter, ambient lighting is everything, especially in the kitchen, if you're in the kitchen a lot like I am. But I kind of just threw my cooking stuff, my avocado oil, butter, salt, that kind of stuff on the tray, and I feel like it looks put together, it's sitting out, it's not too cluttered, and so it works. So I've kind of got cooking stuff going on here, and then, oh, you guys, this pumpkin bread candle from Antique Candle Company. Oh, it smells so good. It smells like a bakery in here. And then I've got some scones in this little cake stand. A sweet friend brought them over to me. I wish I could say I baked them, but I did not. So, but they look really pretty displayed in my kickstand. And I do like to have this out in the fall months because I do a lot of baking this time of year. So just being able to put things on display is always fun. And then I've got my copper pots and pans and tea kettle, which I have out year round. That's not fall. But I think it does look really rich and beautiful during the fall months. I think it's so pretty. But then for my touch of fall in this space, I have an ironstone pitcher over here, and I'm just going to keep it stocked either. I'm going to try to do like weekly flowers for myself. That's something I really enjoy as gardening season ends. And we head into the cooler months, buying myself flowers really helps. I found when it comes to missing gardening and seasonal depression and all of that. So I'm going to try to keep up with that and buy myself flowers as often as I can and just do pretty arrangements in this pitcher. I kept things really simple this first go around. I just bought some pretty orange flowers, and then I think these are little asters. I don't know what they are, but just a pop of color, a pop of fall, and then a sweet little pumpkin next to it. So that definitely brings a smile to my face, and I'm excited to have something to look forward to weekly that I enjoy. So I encourage you, find little things that you can do to bring you joy, that is a form of self-care to you, that helps you through the fall and winter months, because I know I'm not the only one that struggles with that. So yeah, my goal with my kitchen is always to feel minimal in nature, but I still want it to feel cozy and put together. So I think we've got that here in this space.
Well, friends, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope that it gave you some decorating ideas and inspiration and just all the cozy fall feels. If you liked today's video, please do me a favor and give it a big thumbs up, or maybe share it with a friend or a loved one. That helps my channel out more than you know, and I appreciate you so much for being here. Thank you for watching today. I love you guys, and I will see you really soon in my next one. Bye.